Hi, and welcome to this B1 Dashboard e-learning session, where we will look into how to use the tabs groups in dashboard widgets. So let's jump into business one. So out of the box, you get five tabs up here, but these are not the tabs I'm talking about. You can see I put in a few more, and you can make more if you like. But if you have a low resolution, having as many tabs up here end up with the search toolbar being in a drop down instead, so it might not be the best way to have data. So tab groups is an option to put in tabs within the dashboard widget itself. So the sales overview here doesn't use it right now, but let's imagine we wanted to have these three in one tab and these three in another tab, because we want more room so we can actually see the gross values and so on. By definition, you can always do a on the fly maximize, but if you want to see it at the glance without a very big resolution, you might need tabs. So let's go into and edit this dashboard and see what it's all about. And what we need to work with is what is called tab containers. So if we press here, we will get a tab container with page one, and another one, if we press plus here, we get two tabs. So it's quite easy to just drag and drop things in. So on the first tab, we want the sales last month, and you can see the tab immediately ended up becoming that name. And that's because if you only put one thing in a tab, it will automatically take that name unless you right-click and say display item as page. Then it will go back to being having its own title up here. You can go back by right-clicking and saying get back to that. But the minute you drag multiple things in, like for example this, let's move this in as well. You can see the page doesn't have a name because it don't know which of these that you should use, and you cannot use them anymore. So we need to right click and edit the tab, and let's call this last 12 months and top customers, like this. Then on the other tab, let's drag in the three more here so we can get a nice wide room for them so we can actually see the data just out of at a glance like this. Let's call them group statistics. Like this. So if we save this, have a look at it, and we reload our dashboards. You will see that we now have two tabs, so we can see this data in much higher detail. And over here, if we switch to the other tab. So that's just a matter of preference, of course. Do we want it small and use these two to maximize, or do we want to see the big version already at the cost of needing to go to different tabs? Some people also use this in order to hide away different selection options. So for example, this one, we have a lot of selection options over here that affects the data, but it could be that we just want to see the data up front and then have another tab with the selection data. So let's try to go in here and do that. So again, let's make three tabs. So let's call this one calls, this one distribution, and the third one, let's call that selection criteria. Like this. So let's drag in the calls. Let's drag in the distribution. Let's put them in as a 2x2 grid so it's easier to have a look at them. like this. So we can see them in much greater detail. Oops, they didn't go into the group. Let's quickly drag them in there. They were just below the group, so couldn't see it. Now they are in there. And we want to have this one. I just need to show the go in here. Drag this in here, and we want the different selection criteria to be up here. So we have a nice, good, long list of the different options. It's of course all a matter of preference what you like on how to do this. And now everything is done. And let me minimize that so I can show you a small thing at the end. So service now looks like this, with calls, distribution, and selection criteria, spelling errors and all. So this is how you use tabs. The only one thing I want to mention beyond this is the small tools up here. You can see that you can reorder the tabs if you want them in a different manner. You can go to the design and edit the names, just like you do with right click. And in data, you can control if the filters are being used across the different tabs. So if one tab can affect the other distribution tabs or not. So that's up to you if you want to do one or the other. And that's basically it for tabs. Not much to do other than drag drop, put in the new names. This one can confuse a little if you have one and you had another title. So right click and say display item as a tab. But else, thank you for attending this session, and I hope you end up doing a lot of tabs so you can actually do this. By the way, these tabs of course also work in the web version. So if you put them in here, you will also see the tabs in the web version. So with that, thank you for attending. And I hope it was beneficial.